That was a good movie. I'm glad we went.
I told you you'd like it.
It was a little sappy.
Jesse, it was poetic.
Well, now, I don't know if I'd go that far.
Oh, come on. I thought you were an incurable romantic.
Oh, but I am.
Then prove it.
You mean sweep you off your feet, carry you over to my bed, and make mad, passionate love to you?
That would be a start.
The night doesn't have to be over.
Yes, it does.
No, we can go grab a cup of coffee or...
No, coffee just keeps me awake. I probably should get a good night's sleep.
Yeah, I probably should, too.
So I guess I better get going.
Oh, thanks for coming up.
I love you, Jesse.
I love you, too.
Okay, I'll talk to you tomorrow.
What do you want to do tomorrow night?
We can decide at school.
Yeah. I'll see you in the morning.
Good night.
Good night.
So cold in all my life.
What are you doing here in your nightgown?
Why don't you ask your grandfather, the handyman?
What did he do?
What did he do? It's what he didn't do. For 2 years, I've been telling your father the furnace needs to be fixed. But he's too cheap. Un soldo non lo spende. So last night, it starts to make a noise. What does he do? He takes a wrench. And all by himself, he breaks the furnace.
How bad is it?
Oh, I had to open the freezer to warm my hands. But don't worry, I'm on my way to a motel. I just thought you should know in case you thought I was dead or something.
You're not going to a motel, Mom. You're staying right here.
Oh, I couldn't impose.
Where's your bag?
Right outside.
What about Daddy?
Oh, he won't admit he broke it. So I say, fine, let him freeze. I'll just have a nice sleep on the hideaway. You won't even know I'm here.
Ma, you will not sleep on the hideaway. The last time you slept on the hideaway, your back was sore for a month.
Oh, yeah, it still hurts me a little bit, you know. That's an awfully thin mattress.
Come on, we'll put you in Paige's room. She's used to switching beds.
Oh, no, poor girl. I couldn't put her out of her bed. I'll just stay downstairs. I'll be fine. A little back pain. Whew. I've had worse, believe me. I don't want to put anyone to any trouble.
It's no trouble, Ma. You can sleep in Becca's room.
Hear the lonesome whippoorwill. He sounds too blue to fly. Inspector's coming, darling. Best not be fooling around.
Thank you.
That midnight train is whining low. I'm so lonesome I could cry. Jewel.
Do you have to sing that song?
You don't like Hank Williams?
You know what I'm talking about.
It's just a song. Jewel. No, I don't know what you're talking about.
Just drop it.
Now, if you think I was trying to say something, darling, think again. If I have something to tell you, I will just come right out and say it, not serenade you like some lovesick jerk.
Look, I'm sorry. I just meant...
No, I'm sorry.
All right.
Okay?
Okay. It's a nice song.
Yeah.
And you can sing it if you want to.
Yeah.
No, I mean it.
It's dumb.
Artie, would you just sing the stupid song?
Did you ever see a night so long as time goes crawling by?
The moon just went behind the clouds.
I'm so lonesome I could cry. Renee!
Ah, you still can't carry a tune in a bucket, Artie Gordon.
What do you know? When'd you make Inspector?
When they realized all my talents were being wasted.
Well, you're the best looking inspector this old tool belt's ever seen. Renee was a secretary at the DWP.
Oh, gee, you'd never know.
Now, what are you doing working for an outfit called Darlin' Construction?
I'm not working for anybody. I'm the owner.
No.
Co-owner. This is my partner, Paige Thatcher.
You dog!
It's a pleasure.
What an adorable haircut. You look just like a little boy.
What do you want to see first, electrical or plumbing?
Let's start with electricity.
What's it take to pass an inspection these days, darling?
We'll figure out something.
After you.
Oh.
Check out this conduit. Whoa!
You have something against that pencil?
What?
Oh. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm great. Couldn't be better.
Oh, good. Good.
Everything is just same as it's always been.
With Jesse? And that's bad.
No, it's not bad. It's not good. It's just the same.
Maybe you two need to get out more, you know, get your mind off things.
Yeah, maybe.
So what are you and Jesse doing tonight?
I can tell you what we're not doing.
Okay. Then I have a plan.
Good morning.
Unless you have to rush right home after work.
No, my grandmother's taken over my room.
Great. Then you'll come stay with me. Oh, come on, Bex. Trust me.
Double date.
What?
I can't believe she talked you into this.
Oh, Jesse, it'll be a blast.
The word blast and the name Goodman in the same sentence makes me very nervous.
Well, at least it'll be different. Come on. It'll be fun.
Who's she bringing?
Bates.
As in Norman?
Oh, there they are. Goodman. Goodman, we're here.
Having fun yet?
Hi, guys.
Babe, these are my friends, Jesse and Becca.
Hey, Norman.
Sit down, guys.
Boots getting cold?
Mm-hmm. His ribs are great. Goodman. Goodman. Goodman.
What?
Walk me to the bathroom.
I don't have to go.
Now. Excuse me. So this is what you call getting out more, getting your mind off things.
What?
Goodman, watching the two of you go at it does not get my mind off things.
Sorry, I didn't think.
Of course you didn't think.
Look, Becca, I know it's frustrating, but don't blame me.
I'm sorry, it's not your fault. It's nobody's fault.
There are ways to have safe sex, they say.
They don't have boyfriends with HIV.
You just have to protect yourself.
Believe me, I have read everything I could get my hands on. I've called all the hotlines.
And what did you find out?
Each one says something different, but they all say it's a risk.
Everyone is a risk, Becca. Do you see all those guys out there? Any one of them could have it.
But Jesse does have it.
So? You know what you're dealing with? You know to be extra careful.
How careful can you be?
That's for you and Jesse to figure out.
Wow. It's a real good job, Paige.
What?
It's real clean. You even got the burn parts from the moss myrtle trees last year.
Oh. I was just thinking.
About what?
I don't know. It's stupid. Okay, I have this friend. And he's a really great guy.
You're in love again?
No. Absolutely not. He's just a friend, you know? He's a really good friend, and I like him.
Sounds like a great guy.
Yeah, he is.
So what's the problem?
Well, I saw him today with this other woman, and it just really bugged me.
But you're not in love with him?
No.
And that's why you're screaming the pan.
Yeah.
You're so really mixed up, Paige.
I am.
Get in there.
But I never played pool before.
I thought you might like it.
We had to play in front of everybody.
Nobody's watching.
This is kind of a big homework night for me, Paige.
Cork, it's fun. You'll like it.
Can we just watch?
Come on, rack 'em. Never mind. Grab a cue.
Who goes first? Paige.
What?
Who goes first?
Sure. You go first.
Is he here?
Who?
The guy who made you such a goon.
I am not a goon. Just want to make sure he's all right, and then we'll go, okay?
Do I still have to pay pool?
I am being kind of goony, aren't I?
Peg, right?
Paige.
Oh. And this is,
This is my brother.
Oh, hi. Renee.
It's nice to meet you.
Me and Artie have a table in the back. Why don't you join us?
Oh, no, I don't think...
Artie?
We were just about to...
Just a pool.
All right, honey.
Call me Charles.
Okay, Charles, call me anytime.
Hey, Cork, how's it going?
Hey, Artie, how are you?
Never better. How about a game?
Come on.
Hey, let's make it fair. Charles and I can be a team.
Okay.
Guess that means we're partners, partner. Beer?
You break.
Okay.
Couple of beers here.
Got it.
Right! Right!
You left early.
All work and no play, Darla.
Reggie had a problem with the header joist. I had to send everyone home.
Say it again.
There you go.
We may have to go back in and pull the whole rest of the wall, which is a cost that we're gonna have to eat. And I didn't want to make that decision on my own. I tried calling your trailer. There was no answer.
Whoa, darling, whoa. It's not the end of the world.
So where were you all afternoon? As if I didn't know.
If I didn't know better, but I do know better, don't I?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You're shot, sweetie.
Great shot, kid.
I made it.
You're a natural. Come on, let me buy you a soda while the girls re-rack.
Okay.
I ever tell you I once played with Minnesota Fats?
Sure. Your
brother's a little cutie.
This
Maybe we could all play again sometime.
That would be nice.
You and him, me and Artie.
Great.
I hope you're a better carpenter than you are a liar.
What do you mean by that?
Your picture. All sweet innocence, and what you really want to do is whack me with that cue. You thought you had them all to yourself.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, I'm here. I've been here for 6 years. After his wife died, I was the one who took care of him.
Good for you.
But don't think I don't know what's going on. Look at you. Cute little haircut, tight jeans. I see that light in his eyes.
You think I'm interested in Artie?
No. But I think as long as it feels good, you won't stop it.
Let's dance.
I'm not really up for it.
Jesse, please.
I'll dance with you. You mind?
No.
Babe seems like a nice guy.
He'll do.
You really are a cynic, Goodman.
No, I just take pleasure where I can find it. Becca hasn't learned that yet.
She seems happy enough.
You think so?
Don't you think it's frustrating for me, too?
I'm sure it is.
What do you want me to do? Just because I'm HIV positive means I can't have a relationship with someone?
That's not for me to say.
What if it was you?
All I know is, if I were dating someone and we could never... then we'd be just friends. Sorry, Jesse.
Excuse me.
Time?
Yeah, I am now. How about you?
How many times do I have to try to tell you that I'm sorry for the things I've done?
Well, I guess I better be going.
Yeah.
Thank you for the evening.
Thank you.
Do you want to, get together tomorrow night?
Well, let's talk about it tomorrow.
What are we doing?
We're going through our good night routine where we both end up lonely.
I hate it. You go inside to an empty apartment, I go home to an empty room. And all we do is think about each other all night.
I'm open to solutions. We can't.
I'm not talking about doing anything foolish, Jesse. I'm just talking about spending the night. I can sleep on the couch.
And what about your parents?
They think I'm a good man.
Becca.
What?
One pillow or two?
Two. I used your toothpaste and my finger. Not exactly what my dentist would recommend, but for just one night. What are you looking at?
You.
This is so weird.
Is it?
I don't know.
You know what? We have never been together at 1:45 in the morning before. I kind of like it.
Yeah, me too. I could really get used to this.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Would it be so bad?
I love you, Rebecca Thatcher, more than I could ever say. More than... Maybe we should get some sleep.
Yeah, maybe that's a good idea.
You look like a little kid all tucked in like this.
But I'm not.
Don't remind me. Good night.
Good night. You think there's a fire?
Something's always burning somewhere. Good night.
Good night. Jesse. Do you think we could just...
No.
Just hold each other, that's all.
That's not what would happen.
But I want to wake up in your arms. I just want to know what it feels like.
Where were you 2 years ago?
Looking for someone like you.
Go to sleep, Becca.
Thank you. This is insane.
I know.
It's always the same thing. We can't keep doing this.
I know.
I feel like I'm gonna explode.
I'm sorry, Becca. I'm so sorry. I promise this will never happen again.
I just can't do it anymore.
Well, you shouldn't have to. You deserve better. Things are just, they're just gonna have to be different now. From now on, no more kissing. No more hugging, I think, because the problem is, once we get started,
Jesse. No. No, you've got it backwards. The problem isn't what we do. Our problem is that you always stop. These feelings we're having, they're natural, and they're right. That's why they're so strong. Our bodies, our blood, our cells are telling us something. They're telling us that we've reached a point where we want to say something to each other that can't be said with words. I've used up all the words, Jesse. You're fighting a battle you can't win.
Don't talk to me about cells. My cells will kill you.
My sweet love. You are so blind.
I'm not.
You are. When you only think of one thing, one inevitable possibility, so you shut the door on everything. When there are so many ways, so many different beautiful ways we can be together, ways that are safe.
I want to believe you so much.
And trust me. Trust us. We're smart. We can find ways. Don't you want to try?
Do you think that there's an hour, a minute that goes by that I don't think about this? Beautiful, Becca. I live you, and I breathe you. And I'd die tomorrow for the chance to, just for one night, lie in that bed with you. I would give anything. Anything but your life, and that is what we are talking about here.
Sick from kissing your hand?
No.
How about your arm?
Not exactly.
Well, why don't we just deal with that and see what happens? Jesse.
What?
I'm still alive.
Back.
doing out here?
I'm waiting for a cab.
You called a cab at this time of the morning?
Yeah, I want to go home, and I didn't want to bother anyone.
Is the furnace fixed?
No. I couldn't sleep. I miss your grandfather.
Thought you were angry at him.
I am. But someone has to keep his feet warm.
So that's what it comes down to.
Oh, Becca. When you're young, there's fireworks every night. You don't even want to sleep. You don't want to miss a minute. But then you realize that just waking up and hearing him breathe and feeling his warmth next to you is music. And knowing that every morning when you open your eyes, the eyes looking back at you are loving eyes. That's what matters.
What?
I just wanted to be honest, that's all.
You slept with Jesse?
Yes, but not in the way that you think.
Well, how many ways are there, Becca?
A lot of ways. We went as far as it was safe to go, and then we stopped. We slept in each other's arms, and it was wonderful, and I'm not ashamed of it, and I won't apologize for it.
I can't believe I'm hearing this.
If I had taken early graduation and gone away to college this year, I'd be sleeping wherever I wanted.
You can't throw that in our faces, Becca.
I don't mean to upset you guys. I knew you wouldn't be happy about this, but I thought if I was honest, you'd at least be proud of me. I am dealing with something that is really, really hard. Something neither of you had to go through, because when you were in love, you had all the luxuries that I don't. But I'm handling it. And I need you to respect me, and I need you to trust me.
How did this become a conversation about what you need?
Because I thought that's what we were talking about.
Then you're being selfish.
I'm sorry if this hurts either of you. I didn't mean to. But I know I did the right thing.
Becca told us about last night. She was very calm. She was very logical. And I believe she was sincere about what she said.
Mr. Thatcher, you have to believe that we did not do anything that would put her in danger.
I do. I do believe that. But that was this time.
Well, I can assure you...
Don't make promises you can't keep. Jesse, you're 17 years old, and you're not superhuman. What you and Becca are doing is racing full speed toward the edge of a cliff and then sliding to a halt. And one of these times, you're gonna go over.
And what you're saying is that I'm already gone?
Jess, I would give anything if this disease hadn't happened to you. I've grown to love you like a son. But I love my daughter more than life. And I've come here to beg you, if I have to, please, don't take her over that cliff.
And
dumpster's getting kind of full.
Yeah. Hold up, John.
You just gonna leave without saying anything?
Tomorrow, 8 a.m.
That's not what I meant.
What do you want me to say?
That's what I thought.
Artie, wait. Look. I'm sorry about the pool hall. I made a complete fool of myself.
Well, it's about time somebody was a fool around here besides me.
You're not a fool, Artie. You're one of the best men I know. But...
Don't. Don't you dare feel sorry for me.
No, that's not what I was trying to say at all.
Somebody left you. Now you're hurting. You need somebody. So you look around and I'm not very young. I'm not very pretty. I'm not a lot of things, but I'm here.
That counts for something, Artie. More than you know.
Especially when someone else wants me.
Okay. Look, okay. I admit it. She drove me up the wall. I wanted to just rip her red hair out and weave a rug with it.
But now she's gone, and...
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I got kind of used to having all your attention, and I don't know. Maybe you're right. Maybe we shouldn't be in business together. I'm such a goon.
Okay.
Okay, what?
8 a.m. Partner?
Here's your shirt.
Thanks.
I loved wearing it. I smelled like you all day. And I considered keeping it, but then I thought I'd just leave it here. And it could be my shirt for when I stay over.
Becca.
I talked to my parents. They went nuclear, of course, but that's just because they don't understand. But they're just gonna have to get used to it because from now on, you and I are going to be together the way we were meant to be.
Is that what we were trying to prove last night?
We did prove it. We did everything safely and it was fine. It was enough for me.
Well, it's not enough for me.
Jesse, why not?
It's easier for you, Becca, to settle for this much. Because you have a lifetime to have more. This is all I'll ever have.
Well, isn't it better to have a little than nothing at all?
Well, I thought so until last night.
You mean?
I mean, you can't stay over here anymore, Becca. It's just too hard.
But I want to. I need to.
I knew when I met you that I couldn't give you what you needed. And I told you that, but you didn't listen. I'm just sorry that we had to go this far to find out that I was right.
I'm not going to say I don't want to have a relationship. We still have what we have.
Yes, yes, we do.
Then why don't we just forget about all this?
Sure. Do you want to go see a movie or something?
We've seen everything. I better go.
Well, thanks for coming over.
I love you, Jesse.
I love you, too.
I'll talk to you.
What do you want to do tomorrow night?
We can decide at school.
Yeah, I'll see you in the morning.
Good night, Jesse.